in whatever way, in whatever capacity they have. So his disappearance in that sense is auspicious because it gives an opportunity to the devotees to exercise their energy and their inspiration to fulfill those desires in space. Therefore, his disappearance also is an opportunity for greater service. We can think of new ways to expand the movement. Srila Prabhupada, actually, if we look at his activities, it took place over a very short span of time, most of the activities. Of course, there's preparation, as we see from Lilamrita. But actually, his starting point was when he went to America, and then that is how the movement grew. So that, within a period of 12 years, he accomplished everything. Very, very short period of time. You may think that we go through our life and go on and do many things, but we don't realize how long that takes. It may take 20 years or 30 years to do something. And in 12 years, suddenly, he changed the world. A very, very remarkable thing. Of course, we can say that it's not only 12 years because there was preparation. But the starting point by which things began to really expand, was when he went to America. And if he didn't do that, then we'll say that nothing would be the same. So when he went to America, that was the starting of this huge change that took place in the material world. So as Lord Chaitanya has said, the chanting of holy names is the Yuga Dharma, and it should be spread to all towns and villages of the world. And it is the means of creating auspiciousness for the whole world. So this was Prabhupada's vision and his goal, to spread Nam-Sankirtan to all parts of the material world, not for his personal gain, but simply for the benefit of the whole world. This is the best spiritual benefit for everyone. So that was his goal in doing this. And by his efforts within that short period of time, 12 years or whatever, he did it. And he did it in 12 years when he was old. After retirement, he started doing all this activity. Generally, we'll see young people are very active. And as they get older, they do less and less activity, and they're more tired, and whatever, and many physical problems, etc. So, Prabhupada also had physical problems. But nevertheless, he accomplished all of that work within that short period of time, in spite of all those problems. He had, heart problem and diabetes and so many other problems, whatever. All these problems were there. But still, he managed to be very active. He was always traveling. He hardly ever stayed in one place for more than a few days. And he translated Bhanu to other works. And at the same time, he was actively preaching all the time and establishing temples, inspiring devotees, establishing community, going around the world in this way. And in 12 years, he had established all these different things for his followers. So this is a very remarkable thing that he accomplished this in that short period of time. And of course, it's also remarkable that even after his disappearance, it has continued in the same way. We will see that most movements after the disappearance of the leader, then some of the movement seems to quite disappear a lot. And we can see that even with Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, generally the activity started to die down gradually. It certainly didn't increase much. But we'll see with ISKCON actually, it's increased. When Prabhupada disappeared, there were maybe 100 temples around the world. And there were maybe 5,000 devotees. But now we can't really count the number of devotees in let's say, Russia alone, maybe 10,000 devotees, or whatever, like that. So around the world, we can't even count. And number of temples, again, just keeps increasing as the year. So this is quite remarkable that the movement has continued to expand, even with the disappearance of Srila Prabhupada. So the responsibility of the devotees is there to pick up this spirit of preaching and continually think of how to engage more people and spread the name and spread devotional service everywhere. And at the same time, of course, not lose the siddhanta, to keep the correct philosophy and the correct principles at all times. So if this is done, then certainly Prabhupada's goal will be fulfilled, and the whole world will fulfill the Krishna consciousness. So the appearance and disappearance days of the founder and charge of Prabhupada are opportunities for us to think very deeply on how to please Srila Prabhupada with those goals.